you know, anecdotes that you gave, and clearly I think it's something that now is beginning to resonate a lot better. Nothing like before you go to class, reading up your homework, and then coming up, and then listening to the professor talk. You know, then it sinks in. Thank you for that. So, the whole idea, I think this evening, the panel actually that has been put together by Bunty has been a very interesting mix, because we've got Tarun, obviously, the erudite professor, Falguni, who's been a banker most of her life, selling dreams while she's raising capital or selling businesses, but then decided to chase her own dream and now has become a startup entrepreneur. It'll be interesting to hear your perspective and what this transition and the journey has been. Dinesh, who comes from a very, very illustrious family, multi-generational entrepreneurs, have built lots of different very successful businesses and now runs a very successful business himself. And finally, I'll kind of wear the hat of the critic, being a private equity investor. We have a saying in our industry, which is basically, trust must verify, which is kind of like an oxymoron, right? I think Reagan made it very popular when he was negotiating the nuclear, you know, arms treaty with Russia. It's actually a Russian proverb which he picked up and then repeatedly kept telling the Russians, Gorbachev, I think at that point in time, saying that, you know, I trust you, but I would like to verify. And that's our business. Private equity is generally about that. So maybe to kick it off, Dinesh, you've built a very successful logistics business. You've actually gone and not only set foot in, you know, China, but I know that you've built some very successful corridors. And one of the contexts whenever you actually go offshore, and which a lot of Indian entrepreneurs have tried to do that, is that how do you navigate multicultural challenges, community, language, you know, different states, governments, etc. And what is it that you've kind of realized, and how does trust play a role in all of that?
Thanks, Dhanapal. Good evening, everybody. Actually, I 100% empathize with what Tarun was speaking about, of, you know, being the duty of an entrepreneur to build trust, especially when you're coming from a country like India. Because if I go back, we actually started this business in 97, and logistics was a totally unknown word. So when I looked at the first step which we took, which were to set up joint ventures overseas, that's when the TVS brand didn't really matter, because, you know, in India at least people knew it was TVS, there was a you know, value to trust, and people accepted it. So exactly what you said, Dhanapal, when we went actually overseas, we realized that we had to build up the credibility of not just us as individuals or as a company, but also about their acceptance of being owned, so to say, by an Indian company. So I still remember this thing which happened in 2007. So we were looking at an acquisition in UK, and after we had finished all the negotiations, and there was a huge, so to say, angst in their minds about being sold 100% to an Indian entrepreneur or Indian company, then finally, just as we were going to sign the deal, he said that, you know, I really don't want to go ahead, I want to understand more about you. So we actually paid for his ticket to fly to India to see what we had done as, so to say, creating a social ethos around TVS and what a culture which it had built. Met the British Deputy High Commissioner here, and then finally he was convinced enough to go ahead and sign the transaction. And interestingly enough, he signed the transaction just 3 days after the global crisis in 2008. So it took us almost 1 year of convincing before we could actually make the transaction happen. So I think, to look at it, it's not just about multicultural. I think we, in India, I used to believe, being fourth-generation family member, that people tended to value TVS as a brand, as an acceptance. But the moment you stepped out of the country, first it was selling TVS, second was selling Indian as a owner, and last but not the least, and this is where I think the governmental ethos works, I actually found it was very easy and good to work with the British government officials. It was not just the Deputy High Commissioner in Chennai, but including in UK, because this business, this company had a defense business and we had to get security cleared. I was shocked that in 7 days, including individuals like me, were cleared to step into the defense security side of it. And the reason was that was because the Deputy High Commissioner in Chennai, the ambassador in Delhi, actually said, oh, you know, TVS is such a trusted brand, we can live with it. I think I had the benefit of having the trust, but I had to build it overseas.
Super, thanks a lot. Maybe just to kind of dive into Falguni's side, right?